Hello everyone, Alchemicgree here, welcome back to Spyro the Dragon. Last video we finished up the, I believe, Peacekeepers world, and we're going to be heading off to doing the next world. And I gotta say, after doing two of these videos so far, this is definitely going to be a very short playthrough, but at the same time, there's still at least the other two games to consider.
I can't believe how fast you found so much stolen treasure. Hop aboard for the
Magic Crafters,
world,
that's where we're going
ready.
Next. Alright. Keep bouncing on his head, and he just rubs it like, oh, wow, you're such an asshole, Spyro. I think Spyro's very young in this era. Still, you know, he's still like a... I don't know if he's a baby dragon, but he's definitely younger compared to the others, since everyone else is a 12-foot-tall behemoth. He's like 3 feet at the shoulder. Maybe even 3 feet at the horns. Alright, it's nice. Oh my god, that was so lucky. That was so goddamn lucky.
Welcome to Magic Crafters. I want you to release the dragons, reclaim our treasure, and recover the eggs from those pesky blue thieves.
So this at least definitely puts me on top of friggin'. Oh man, that's also wow. I am so goddamn lucky right now with those egg thieves. Okay, there we go. Oh god, the green gem's hiding in the grass.
When you see arrows like these, you can charge along with them to begin a supercharge.
Supercharge? Excellent!
Go ahead, try it.
That is one thing I think is really good about this, how they is, Wow. That was nice. Okay. I do like how they basically gave every dragon a somewhat unique enough appearance. Like, I don't think I saw enough where, like, two looked so close to the same that I could say, oh, it's just the same guy, but reskinned. Like, there are so many different combinations of basically head to body, head to torso to arm to horn ratios.
This portal leads to a special place where you can learn to fly. I remember when I was a young dragon, earning my wings.
Learn to fly. Got it.
There we go.
Hmm.
There we go. But yeah, like,
oh, Spyro, you're not afraid of those big, noisy, gigantic, awful beasts, are you?
Of course not.
Oh, good. I didn't think so.
Yeah, so the only downside about this, like I think I said in a previous video, there's just really not much to talk about. It's kind of set forward in its ways. Like, once you kind of get it all going, it's that's pretty much it. This is the game. It's like four or five worlds. It's like, or I think it's like maybe four worlds. If it's four or five, there's always one world about just dedicated flying. There's just been a bunch of worlds about running around doing random stuff, and that's about it. There's not much to it. It's pretty straightforward.
Oh, you wizard dicks.
For releasing me.
Stay down, stay down. Don't have to get up. There we go. I like that. I knocked him out of his mount. He tries to walk away all casual, like, oh, doinky doink, I didn't see anything.
If you keep this up, you'll learn all the tricks of the magic crafter's world.
Ah, goddammit.
These blue thieves have stolen eggs outside the magic crafter's world as well.
Don't worry, I'll take care of them.
All right, there's the dragons.
Thank you.
really ran for it. There we go. So the gems, the dragons. I think I just have to get this egg. That'll be all done. You gotta do it, like, right as a turn. I can't be lucky every time. Damn it. Oh, you fuck. Even stop for a split goddamn second. Mocked me. There we go. Alright, level done. Am I, like, interrupting a wizarding war? Ah, goddammit. Like, the green wizards versus the blue wizards, because they look to be fighting each other, and all I'm doing is just killing both sides.
Something about these green druids. They insist on moving everything in sight.
They're druids. So it's blue wizards versus green druids? Or are they druids because they're green?
those bugs. When I become big and strong like you, I'll squash them all.
Until then, remember that supercharge makes you invincible.
It makes... Oh, I didn't even know it made me invincible. I'll take that. Don't stop running. I'm invincible. Alright. Big bugs. Didn't expect that, did ya? Fucking giant bug. My super breath attack. That went a little better than I thought it did. Thought it would.
Try combining your supercharge with jumping and gliding, and really explore the high caves.
All right, all the dragons. Very nice. God. What the hell? What the frickin' fairy blessing? What the hell was that? That should have totally been instant death. There's like nowhere for you to run! This is the dumbest egg thief I've ever... What? That didn't even have a scene attached to it! Did like the developer just give up halfway? Oh, I think I get it. It's because there's actual no way off that area without death. So they do it like that. Okay, I guess. I guess that's how that makes sense. I like the effects of the interior. That looks really nice. How did the sheep get here? This is kind of like islands kind of floating out in a foggy abyss. Gotta wonder, like, I mean, yeah, it's not really supposed to make sense. I don't really care. You're not really supposed to care much for the ecology of the world you're running around in, especially in a fantasy game from, God, I don't know. When, this game either came out in the late 90s or early 2000s.
Welcome to Wizard Peak. This is my favorite supercharge spot. Use it to bash those wizards.
If the arrows were pointing that way. Oh well. Oh, you sneaky little shit. Like, why? Why would there even be an egg? Like, what? So we could just run in goddamn circles? Okay, are the fairies gonna help me again? Or is that just... Okay, never mind. Oh, you stupid asshole. Asshole Gnor. Oh my god, you fucking dick. Ya dick. Yep. You're supposed to go like super fast or just like not at all. And whoop. Oh, you. Oh my god. Oh my god. No, so the arrow was going the other direction. I was wrong. Boop. Aha. Fuck you.
Well done, Spyro. Thank you for releasing me.
You know, I like the architecture, but after a while it just gets really repetitive and you just run in goddamn circles. Okay. Is there anything I missed? Not here. Oh, that one gem. Oh, it is so endlessly frustrating. It's like probably something in a stupid fucking corner I missed. No, it's fine. It's fine. It's fine. We got this. It's just... Oh, boy. One gem. You know, the fact that it actually took a while before we even reached that point where I could get here, just fall to my death. Oh my god. Oh my god. The fucking game glitched! This guy out of existence and I had to die? You bitch!
Listen carefully, Spyro. There's a secret area in the Artisan's home world near the waterfall. Try jumping on the stones there.
Artisan's home world? Waterfall. Sounds good.
Yeah, you know, the thing I already did before. Nice try. Oh yeah, that is just beautiful. That's just beautiful. How you fucking asshole. Druids. All right. You just have the bell spout. Blow hard. All right, that's fine. Thank you. Ugh. I kind of want to feel like I think I have an idea of what's caused all this. I think it was the fact of when Gnasty Gnorc stopped the other dragons encased in crystal. I think it's like it caused all the other problems that the dragons were keeping at bay.
Thanks for releasing me, Spyro. You have no idea how long I've been trapped in crystal, and neither do I. Who are you again?
I'm out of here.
Yeah, I think that was it. I think that was it. Like, maybe these druids were already a problem in this area, but the dragons were taking care of it. But then, with the dragons encased in crystal, the druids started having issues, and the wizards started taking issues, and it became a turf war. I think that's what it was. So all we're doing is basically cleaning up. Easy. All right, yeah, so. Gonna drove for the next one in the next video. So, thank you all so much for watching. Share, subscribe, let me know what you think. Leave comments below, and I'll be with you next time. Thank you, and goodbye.